Good afternoon, students. I hope you all are fine. See, in the first lesson, moreover, we had seen about the Vijayanagar and Bahmani kingdom. Is it so? It's okay. So now, in the second lesson, we are going to see about the Mughal Empire. Okay, Mughal Empire. So before seeing the Mughal Empire, I need to give some new introduction. Okay. So introduction means, a new empire began in our India with the arrival of the Mughal king Babur. Okay, he only made the foundation for the Mughal empire. Okay, so except for the brief region of Sersha of Sar dynasty, the Mughal ruler has lasted from AD 1526 to 1707. Okay, so these were the years when the fame of great Mughals of India spread all over the Asia and the Europe. Okay, so who started the Mughal empire? Babur. Okay, so Mughal kingdom, the first king of Mughal king is Babur. Okay, so this was the years when the fame of great Mughals of India spread all over Asia and the Europe. So after the six great Mughal emperor, the empire began to the disintegrate. That only we are going to see this. Okay, so the first we are going to see about the Babur. Okay, so Babur, his ancestry and his moreover his early career. Okay, Zahiruddin Muhammad Babur is popularly known as the Babur. Okay, his original name is Zahiruddin Muhammad Babur. He was the founder of the Mughal Empire in India. See, the term Mughal, it will be traced to Babur's ancestors. Okay, so the feudatories of Babur is called as the Mughals. So that only it's called as a Mughal Empire. Okay. So Babur, he was a great grandson of the Timur. Okay, that means his father's side. His father's side, he was the great grandson of the Timur. On his mother's side, his grandfather was Yunus Khan of Tashkent. That means he was known as the great Khan of the Mongols. Okay, great Khan of the Mongols. And the 13th in the direct line of the descent of the Genghis Khan. So Babur was born in 14th February 1483, and he was named as the Zahiruddin Muhammad. Okay, so Zahiruddin means it's a meaning of defender of the faith. What's it? Defender of the faith. Okay, so he inherited Fergana. Fergana means it's a small kingdom in the Central Asia. Okay, so when he was 12 years old, he was soon driven out from there by the Uzbeks. Okay, the people who are known from the Uzbekistan is called as the Uzbeks. Okay, so while he was in the 12 years, he inherited the Fergana, but he was driven out from there by the Uzbekistan. So after the 10 years of adversity, Babur established himself as the ruler of the Kabul. Okay, this is the story of Babur. Okay, so the foundation of Mughal Empire in our India, the foundation of the Mughal Empire in India. See, so in Kabul, Babur set his sights eastward, remained by the territory of Timur's Indian invasion in the 1505. Okay, so the very year after he took Kabul, Babur led his first expedition towards the India. Okay, in the first time he came to the India in 1505. Okay, so he was preoccupied with the Central Asian affairs. See, he did not have any ambition beyond the Punjab till 1524. Before that, he was capturing the other country, but he was entering into the India in 1505. Okay, but he was not interested to capture the Punjab after which year? Till 1524. So there was a great opportunity came knocking of Dilwar Khan, who was the Daulat Khan Lodi's son. Okay, in the previous lesson we had seen, is it not? So Dilwar Khan, who was the Daulat Khan Lodi's son, and Alam Khan, who was the uncle of Sultan of Delhi, arrived in Kabul to seek the Babur's help for the war. Okay, so in that time only, Babur helped in removing the Ibrahim Lodi from the power, Babur defeated the Ibrahim Lodi to the famous Battle of Panipat in 1526. We had seen about the Battle of Panipat, is it no? So, and occupied the Delhi and Agra. So, following that, Babur's victory in this battle. So, Mughal dynasty came to be established in the India with the Agra as its capital. Okay, capital at Agra. So, in this way only he was the founder of the Mughal Empire in the India. Okay, so shall I repeat this again? Okay, see, up to 1505 he captured the other country and other territories. Okay, so he was he came to the India in 1524, but he was not interested to capture the Punjab. But who is asking the help to him? Daulat Khan Lodi son and Alam Khan, they are seeking the help to Babur to fight over against the Ibrahim Lodi. So Babur is also helping them, and Babur is making the inventions against the Ibrahim Lodi. Okay, so he was defeating them in the Battle of Panipat in 1526, and after that Babur's victory in the battle, he established his empire in the name of the Mughal Empire in the India. So what was the capital? Agra was the capital. Okay, understand? Okay. So next we are going to see the Babur's military conquest. Babur's military conquest. So first Babur defeated the Rana Sangha. Okay, if you see the picture, you can see that he is the king of Rana Sangha. He is a very powerful king, but he was easily defeated by the Babur. Okay, so Babur defeated the Rana Sangha and his allies at Kanwa in 1527. Okay. He won the war against the chief of Chanderi in 1528. Okay. And he prevailed over the Afghans and chief of Bengal and Bihar in 1529. Okay. So, Babur died in 1530. Okay. Babur died in 1530. Before he could consolidate his victories, Babur was a scholar in Turkish and the Persian languages. He was a great scholar in the Turkey and Persian languages. So the main points I had given in the screen, just please underline in the books. If you are having the books, just follow with the books, and moreover you can underline the main one words with the books. Okay, so first one, Babur defeated the Rana Sangha in 1527, that you need to underline that. And next one, he won the war against the chief of Chanderi in 1528. Okay, and he was a great scholar in Turkish and Turkish and Persian languages. Okay, he recorded his impressions about the Hindustan. Okay, Hindustan means, moreover, its animal, plants and trees, flowers and fruits in his own autobiography. Okay, so that means he given the very famous name of the autobiography in the Babur's autobiography book, Tuskai Baburi. Okay, Tuskai Baburi. Just underline that. He wrote his autobiography in the name of Tuskai Baburi. Okay, so following the tradition set by the Changir Khan, he nominated the most deserving among his sons in his higher. Higher means moreover the generations. Okay, higher means generations. So Babur chose his favorite and the elder son of Humayun as his higher. Okay, did you understand this? Okay, so whatever thing we had seen that, so what is the name of Babur? Babur original name is Sahiruddin Muhammad Babur. Okay, Sahiruddin Muhammad Babur. He was the founder of Mughal Empire in the India. Okay, so moreover he inherited the Fargana, a small kingdom of Central Asia. But what happened? But in the 12 years he was drawn up from that places. Okay, so after his hard work and after the 10 years of adversity only, he again re-established the ruler of the Kabul. Okay, so and made the capital as the Agra. Okay, and foundation of Mughal Empire also we had seen, and after that Babur's military conquest. Okay, so Babur defeated the Rana Sangha in 1527. He won the war against the chief of Chanderi in 1528, and moreover he was a very well scholar in Turkish. Sorry, I can mention the Turkey, but it's a Turkish and Persian languages. Okay, and he wrote the autobiography, the name of Tuskai Baburi. So in the Tuskai Baburi, he written the well fame of the Hindustan. The whatever thing is very famous in the Hindustan, he wrote it everything. Okay. So and at last, after his death, Babur chose his favorite and elder son Humayun as his heir. Okay. So next class we can see over the remaining thing. And moreover, thank you. We can see over in the next class. Be safe and read the lesson. Just underline the important one words. Okay, ma. Thank you.